What will you do now? Slip out the back way to avoid them and make for home. Step out to face the crowd. Okay. Nope. Not gonna deal with it. I'm just gonna leave. Don't want it. You sneak away from the waiting crowd, change costume, and make for home. At home, you have had an exhausting day fighting fucking 4 radiation dogs that could have killed you if they bit you. And you slump in front of the TV with a long, cold drink. A long drink? Okay. Isn't like a freaking, like, tiki glass thing? I don't know. Nice work. You gained 6 stamina points. You certainly needed the rest. Yes, because I lost. I only took 1 damage from somebody fucking hitting me in the shin or whatever. What? Oh, no, in the thigh. Some random person hitting me in the thigh. Okay. Next morning, you leave for work early. You catch a bus, but to refresh yourself before work, you get off and walk the last half of the journey. Typical. As soon as I get off the bus... okay. Typical. As soon as I get off the bus, it starts to rain. You begin to run, but slow down when you arrive at Cowfield Dairy. What? Why is there a dairy in the middle of the city? Shouldn't those usually be near the farms or something? I don't know. I mean, I guess they could be, but... They would have to keep the cow... No, whatever. Something doesn't quite seem right besides there being a dairy in the middle of the city. What is your next move? Go and investigate, make one way to work. Perhaps there is something I can solve here. Try to solve your clues. Match the correct clues to their events to solve the crimes. Tap clue to use it. I only have 2 clues. This is something about the dairy, but that's not gonna... No, I don't think I have any clues that will work with that. Let's go investigate. Investigate! I'm probably going to lose my job, but at least the rain is clearing. Cowfield Dairy. I guess they get the milk from the farms and they haul it over here, I guess. So I guess that makes sense. When you arrive at the gates, everything seems in order. Milk trucks are returning from their daily rounds and thousands of bottles are chinking their way along conveyors. There is no sign of danger. Oh god. A short-tailed tabby cat, no doubt astray, is trying to get in through the gates. You pick up the hungry creature and stroke it. As you wait, your eye catches a familiar-looking figure turning the corner and walking towards you. It's Chainsaw Bronski. I was going to say Broski, but Bronski. You thought this nefarious murderer was behind bars. Bronski was once a no-good regular thug, not too high on the criminal ladder. But after he decided to use a chainsaw as a gimmick, petty robbery wasn't enough. I have a chainsaw. I'm going to rob you. And it's like, you see it. It's scary. His criminal patterns changed. And soon he was single-handedly robbing banks. Yes, because nobody can see some guy walking towards a bank with a chainsaw and say, maybe I should do something about that. And breaking into museums, vandalizing art he didn't like, and stealing everything else that wasn't nailed down. If he's out on the streets again, that can only mean trouble. Where do you go from here, Hand of Fate? With the needy, I want to take the cat to a cat. No. The cat's probably that freaking villain that transforms into a cat, but we gotta take care of this guy first. Bronski's crime spree hits its grotesque peak at murder. It was only then that he was finally captured. Really? But he's clearly escaped. I need to stop him. You hide behind the gate until Bronski is close. You hear his heavy boot steps. What now? Hand of Fate. Spring out to confront him. Okay, I'm not gonna do a surprise attack and just blast him. And that doesn't seem very heroic. So we're gonna confront him first. You spring out to confront him.
What? What? Hand of Fate?
The startled killer reaches into his coat and pulls out a battery-powered chainsaw. Did I say powdered? I don't even know. He starts it up menacingly. Now it's time for a battle. Rub a cat against you for a charge zap. Here, kitty that I picked up. I'm going to rub it against you so I can charge myself. I'm going to rub you and you're probably that woman. And she's going, oh my god, why are you rubbing me against you? Oh my god, this is sexual harassment. Anyways, your zap strikes Chainsaw Bronski and there's a smell of cooked meat. Ew. Human meat? That's kind of gross.
I vulse you.
Really? Chainsaw Bronski rushes towards your right arm, trying to chop it. Oh god, so it chops you right in. Oh god, he actually hit me. Fuck. Would my arm be gone? I took 2 points of damage. My arm should be gone. Vroom. But now I'm gonna fucking, like, rub your hand. I'm gonna fucking zap you again. God damn it. Seven aliens, rub your hands together for a stunning result. Whoosh. Because lightning goes whoosh sometimes. Your stunning result is a bitter disappointment. Oh, did I not? Oh, you missed? Really? Fuck. Imagine he starts to... Okay, he's trying to slice my nose, really? Okay, the chainsaw whizzes past you, ready for another attack. Okay, let's try to hit him again. Rub your hands together, Telsa blast, fire! You do a little dance, but you rub your hands together for an alternating Telsa blast. Bzzink! Your attempt to strike chainsaw, there is a burning smell. Take that, 4 damage. You emerge victorious. Chainsaw Bronski lies unconscious on the ground. Woo, I just earned another fear card. Get better cards. Unwrap my... Do I want to spend my... No. Let's unwrap my card now. Devastator. I don't even know what it does. Oh, but there we go. Uptown. You take the murderer to the police headquarters, which is thankfully only a couple of blocks away.
Don't turn me in, Hand of Fate. I can't go back inside. Please.
No dice, Bronski. Your freedom is about to be cut short. Ha ha ha. Ha.
Yeah, did you get that joke? Because you have a chainsaw? Yeah.
I've got some info on the serpent that could help you. Be a pal, Hand of Fate.
I wish I could just say I would want to listen and still throw him into jail, but that's probably not going to be... Well, it says listen. It doesn't say I'm going to let him go. And any tips I could get might help. So I'm going to listen to what he has to say. Let's see. You've heard of the serpent, right?
Of course. He rates just a little higher on the useless scumbag ratings than you do.
His girlfriend, Lola Manche, she's dumped him.
What a shame. So what?
Come on, Hand of Fate. You know the serpent. He's obsessed with Lola. Obsessed.
Lola Manche is well known in Titan City. Let me see. I lost my... thing here. Anyway, treading the boards in the theater district, she was famous for her quote.
I don't want to be a star. I just want to be an ordinary girl. Why you look like a mouse? What?
Okay. She always takes the poorest of dressing rooms when performing. What? Why? Why is that? Okay.
Sounds like she decided to end her life of decadence with the serpent, too.
This is certainly surprising news and could prove useful.
You found a clue. A clue.
There's blues clues. You know what to do. Not continue singing this song. There's only one thing to do.
Hand him over to the authorities. Thank you for the information, but you're still going.
I'm not going to let you go. Yeah, thanks for the information, but you're... You hand Bronski over to the police sergeant at the desk.
I would like to say to the police, it's like, hey, he kind of helped me out, so if you want to go slightly easy on him, he is a murderer,
but he did kind of help with an investigation, so maybe take away his life sentence, like, and give him, like, one year less, or something. I don't know, whatever.
A present for you, Sergeant. What's this? Chainsaw Bronski?
Wait, what? You said...
I said nothing of the sort. I said nothing, Bronski. Have a nice time in the penitentiary.
With another good ding. He didn't really say... I never said I was going to let him go for information. He offered it to me, but he never said it was in exchange for anything. Anyway, with another good deed performed, you leave the police headquarters. You must start thinking about getting back to... Yeah, I haven't even freaking gone to work yet, so I'm going to have to... Oh, great. It's raining. Outside, it's starting to rain. Just your luck. Let's get to work. Let's see. Can I solve something here? Match the correct clues to their events to solve the crimes. Okay, let's see here. And click this. Wait, no. I don't lose it. But, I mean, this doesn't do anything. Like, I'm clicking these. Okay, that's not correct clue. Serpent, you're somewhere. Okay, I guess that doesn't do anything. Let's just go back then and change back to normal clothing. And I'm probably gonna be fired, late for work again. And my outfit is just a hat and glasses.
You turn the corner to the Clark Street. Really? Clark Street? You stop you past Harold's department store. A thought crosses your mind. No. I could stop by and buy Jonah a present, some kind of apologize for me. No. This makes me let's just fucking get to work. We're already late. Just get there. Oh, great. At the office, no sooner as you step through the office door than Jonah White's blooming voice summoned you.
Get in here at once.
You creep into his office, mumbling excuses for being late again.
Enough! What do you think we're running here, a charity? You suppose I should be grateful that you even grace us with your presence?
I just...
Very noble of you indeed even bother coming in at all. You can have the rest of the day off without pay. I got fucked.
But I...
If you're not in first thing tomorrow morning, you can start looking for another job.
Dot, dot, dot. No.
Dot, dot, dot.
Achievement unlocked. 3-day weekend. Get suspended from work for it. Great. I try to do good and I get fucking yelled at work, of course. You slink out of his office with your tail between your legs, even though I don't have a tail. I guess my cape, which is obviously flapping the breeze, but nobody gives a damn.
How can I tell him what I've been doing?
And now you've been suspended for a day. Wherever you go, okay.
Avoid all contact with the outside world and go home.
No, let's go to the Wisneyland. Really? Wisneyland? Whatever, let's go to the amusement park. Wisneyland is swarming with holiday makers enjoying their day out at the amusement park. Happiest place. Spend them time at Wisneyland. There are screams from delight from children running around with glee.
What a lovely afternoon.
The smell of candy floss and hot dogs hang in the air. As you stroll about, youngsters clutching stuffed animals run laughing past you. Screams of delight from roller coaster riders turning through the corkscrew break through the general hubbub. You're going to enjoy yourself today. What do you want to try? The Big Deep Dipper, the Fun House? What the hell is a Dodge-em? Let's not... So the roller coaster or Fun House? Let's go on the roller coaster. Screw it. You climb into a carriage behind a couple with a young daughter. Time for something a bit more adventurous. If this is more adventurous and I'm a superhero, I'm a pretty sad superhero, really.
I'm scared, and you are very, very creepy looking. God damn.
The ride hasn't even started yet,
you big sissy. Little sissy, something. As you set off up the long climb, the excitement is mounting. Squeals come from the riders as the first steep drop lifts their stomachs.
Whee!
It is not until you reach the first sharp bend that you notice the danger. Oh, crap.
That girl's safety harness. It's frayed to almost nothing.
What? How? Really? You need to work on your maintenance skills, Wisneyland.
As you shriek into the bend and are wrenched to the right, the harness snaps and the girl lurches across the carriage. That's not good.
Help me! Help me!
Can you rescue the girl before she falls to her death? Test my skill. Uh-oh, I am going to fuck up. You strain to reach the screaming girl. Oh, okay, I got her. Holy crap. Test your skill. You are successful. Successful. Didn't sound like anything else. Not at all. You react quickly and save the young girl from a grisly fate. Quick as a flash, you reach forward and grab the girl in the nick of time before she plunges to certain death. You've just gained 2 hero points. When the ride is over, her parents rush over and thank you. The young girl is distraught but happy.
Thank you so much. You saved my life.
I'm just glad you're safe. And every time I go in my superhero voice, I put my fists on my sides. I go into superhero pose because it helps me get into character. Yeah.
You decide you have enough of Wisneyland for one day. Yes, that is pretty much enough. Where are you heading as you leave Wisneyland? I may go downtown to do some shopping, head home and rest. Theater or shopping? I don't want to go home right now. Fucking got the day off without pay. Might as well do some stuff.
Let's do some shopping.
Strolling downtown, you first stop at the bank to get some cash. Next stop is a pizza parlor for a bite to eat.
hamburger filled crust, my favorite.
Hamburger filled crust on a pizza? Really?
I know you can put hamburger on top of pizza, but I've never heard of it being filled, like, filled in the crust. What the hell is that? Actually, it doesn't sound too bad. You take a stool facing out across Banner Street and watch the shoppers passing as you eat your pizza. Oh, hey, that's Drew Swain over there. Drew Swain? Oh, my God. Drew Swain? Bruce Wayne? Really? God damn it. Swain is a retired millionaire who made his fortune manufacturing the collection tins used by charities. What? He manufactured collection tins? Oh, my God. He stepped into a bakery, and when he comes out, something strange happens. He takes a step forward and suddenly freezes, held like a statue in an off-balance pose. What's happened to Swain? A blue van draws up in a scourge view. When it dries off, he's gone. Really? A van came up, somebody was frozen, and they're gone. You saw it with your own eyes, but it happened so quickly that you are now a long way behind the kidnappers. Way to have reaction time, dude. Will you dash to the toys in the back of the shop and change costume? Follow the van? I'm gonna follow the van. Fuck it. I'm gonna lose him. Let's just go. You fiends, come back here with Mr. Swain. But by now, it is long gone. Give up and resume. Really? Really? Great. Now I don't even have any information. I should have just gone. Can't I just go back and freaking ask for information now? Why do I just want to leave and just go continue on my way and continue shopping? Hopefully I get a bit of peace for the rest of the day. There are plenty of shops to visit in Titan City. Two catch your eye immediately. Virgin Records and Epiphanies, the famous jewelers. Perhaps I should pick up a new record, or maybe something nice for Aunt Florice. Aunt Florice, really? Let's just go check out the latest albums. Okay, shopping done. Heading back to the shops, you enter Virgin Records. The store is absolutely packed. What's going on? Haven't you heard Michael Jackson's... really? Michael Jackson's newest album's out. Hee-hee. Michael Jackson? He's my favorite singer. What is it? Oh my God. I can't stand this. It's almost getting too much. It's called Chiller. It's all about spooks and ghouls. It'll be the top of the pops. Man, dude, bro. With such a glowing endorsement, you grab a copy before Virgin runs out of stock entirely. I can't wait to get home and listen to it. But should you check your crime watch first? Yes, let's check the crime watch. You check your crime watch to see if anything else is happening. It remains silent. Now would be a good time to check over any clues you have found today. Remember, you can do this anytime by opening the menus and selecting clues. Oh, wait, okay, selecting the menu, okay, I think we did this, clues, here are all the clues you're got. I only had 3 clues right now, god dang, I didn't get any new ones, so back to story, it remains silent, okay, clicking clues, head for home, at home, you get home and enjoy a delicious meal, phew, how exhausting, being the hand of fate sure isn't easy. Yeah, you have a lot to deal with, like not like beating up dogs and then not saving people that are frozen. Really good. It's tiring to try to save the world every day. Nice work, you just gained 6 stamina points. You're relieved to finally get into bed. Okay. I think my brain is starting to hurt from all the freaking puns and bad references, and I think I gotta take a break. I'm gonna call it for right now. But anyways, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, you can like, comment, helps me out. If you want to keep up with everything, you can subscribe to me on YouTube, you can follow me on Twitch and Twitter, or you can do all of them. It'd be good. But until next time, take care, guys.